Bow, bang, hello. Yay. Mm.
Sucker's gotta put up with me now.
This outfit will make or break this wedding.
I think we have found the one. Looks like it was meant for your wedding.
Oh my God, you're so awesome.
Are you ready?
Let's do it. Oh, oh my God. I love it.
This is the one.
You're the one. Baby, I love the red bow tie,
mm-hmm.
the gray collar, and he can be our ring bearer.I'm Ed, also known as Big Ed, and I'm a very young 56.
I'm Liz. I'm 29 years old.
I thought you were 49. You look so cute. Liz and I have been engaged for 4 months. It was on again, off again for about a year and a half prior to that. But now we're engaged for real.
No more off and on.
Oh, my God. Look, he's checking himself out.
This is absolutely perfect.
Leon, he'll be the perfect ring bearer. I've struggled with love all my life until I went into a restaurant one day and met the girl of my real dreams. And of course, she fell in love with me immediately.
No, I dodged you for months.
I think you're amazing. And I want to ask you out on a date.
When I first met Ed, he came in kind of sad.The first couple months, he always brought women into the restaurant as a hangout or date.
Why was that sad? Why wasn't sad?
It was never the same girl. But after Ed let his guard down with me, I got to know Ed and not Big Ed.
How about lunch tomorrow?
Brunch?
Brunch, I love it.
Brunch, okay.
Okay. There are a lot of things that I was working through when we were together. I was insecure, jealous, and it started to affect our ability to be in a functional relationship. So I actually thought you were on a date. And I'm like, here we go again. I like somebody, and it's gonna fail.
There's nothing between us.
Okay, hold on 1 second. And then I saw you guys walk into your car one night.
I'm not gonna stop hanging out, like having my own life and being independent.
So eventually, our fighting became too much. So I decided to end it once and for all. I basically broke up with her 8 times via text. They were always text.
As the texter.
Right. And then Teddy passes away, my dog.He just kept looking at me that night, like he knew he was going somewhere. And I probably dozed off for like maybe 30 minutes, and I woke up and he was gone. So Liz was one of the very first people to reach out to me.
I just at least needed to show you that he was loved and you were loved.
One thing led to another.
Yep.
Bow, bang, hello. Yay. Mm.
Sucker's gotta put up with me now.
You look great, baby. How are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
You smell great, too.
We just finished happy hour, so.
Oh, you just finished happy hour. Oh.
We're about to start second happy hour.
Yeah. Now that we're engaged, we want to throw an engagement party to kind of celebrate this moment of us making it this far.
So today, we're going to go out and check out a venue. I want great food, classy environment, and Malbec. Ooh, this is
we
nice.
Call this our sunset rooftop deck.
This
yeah,
is beautiful.
Sunsets that way. I think this might be a good space for the size of group you have. So you're completely private up here.
I love that part.
Why don't I let you be? And if you have any questions, I'll be around tonight.
Very nice.
All right. Nice to meet you all.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Tawny and J-Lo are two of my best friends. They are my bridesmaids. They were with me at my darkest days through my breakup with Ed.
Got some shots all around. These are some reposados.
Ooh, so fancy, Ed.
I understand that everybody in my world is still getting used to the idea that Ed and I are back together, but I do appreciate their support because I know a lot of people in Ed's worlds don't approve of the engagement.
Here's to the importance of friendship and
love.
Thank you for being a part of our wonderful day.
Thank you so much for having us.
Cheers.
In the beginning, I definitely was skeptical. When I got that phone call, Liz called me. She's like, I have something to tell you. And I'm like, what? And then she's like, we're engaged. And I was shocked. I had very strong feelings because I saw how hurt she was and what she went through.
And I was kind of hoping she would be like, I would never go back with him.
I mean, I hope he doesn't break up with her a ninth time. There was 8 breakups.
Yeah.
There was 8 breakups. That's a lot of breakups.
It's a lot of breakups.
So what's going to make it different this time?
Good question. Most of it was my issues. So I felt I had to grow in order to be with her. And I realized she was what I wanted. And I knew I could handle it. I knew I was ready.
And he's the one that I love, and he's the one that I want to be with. I love Ed because, yes, we had a really rough patch for a while, but Ed has shown me love in ways that I've never had with any previous relationship. He shows his love for me, too, with the love that he has for my daughter, and I think that was the biggest thing that made me fall in love with Ed. And now we have a party to plan.
Who's all coming?
My grandparents are gonna hopefully be meeting his family.
Wow.
So on my side, the announcement of our engagement didn't quite go as expected. Like, I really don't know. My daughter, you know, she was naturally shocked and upset.
She called everybody before he
had an before I had an opportunity
to call people,
to tell my brothers, to tell my mom and my buddy Rich, my ex-buddy Rich. They just don't understand that the person sitting next to me is my future. Mm-hmm. This is who I want. And that's the conversation I'm getting ready to have with Rich. I'm like, look, I thought you were my friend. After Liz and I got back together, a lot of my friends and family didn't understand why. When we first broke up, Liz said a lot of, you know, bad things about me. And I think they're afraid that she's going to do that again. I've tried to reach out to my daughter, Tiffany, and she, at this moment, she's not taking my calls. And Rich is somebody that I've known for 15 years. And after we got engaged, you know, he said a lot of bad things. And I want to know why he can't accept the fact that I've chosen Liz. So I'm going to say, hey, look, Rich, I thought you were my friend. You know, quit talking to my mom. Let me have a conversation.
Wait, she's talking to your mom?
He talks to her like every day.
That's bizarre.
It's very bizarre.
What is going on with your mom and you?
So she kind of felt like, oh, you're picking Liz over me. I'm like, I'm picking me over me, and I'm in love with Liz. To be honest, we're not in a good place. Unfortunately for my mom, when she found out we got engaged, I think her reaction was, you got to be kidding me.
We, on both sides, got rid of negative people. His mom's no longer living at the house.
Okay. Ed, how does your mom feel about your engagement to Liz?
She's not happy because she feels like I'm choosing Liz over her. I had so many people telling me how I felt about Liz, and they wanted me to break up with her.
I don't like the fact that, like, I feel like I'm being blamed for something.
No.
And I came back into this relationship.
What? It wasn't fair to Liz.
No, yeah.
Because now she's taking the blame.
Yeah. Now she's getting put as like the villain, and like that's not fair.
In the past, when Ed and I would break up, he would talk about all our problems to everybody, and I always looked like the bad person, and they would convince him just to break up with me. So there is a fear that these people can come back into his life and
convince him not to be with me.
I've had enough. I'm tired of burning bridges, but I keep hearing demons inside. Can you shake these voices out my head?
I am heading to meet up with Rich. You know, your friends, I know, are there to protect you. I think he somehow feels he's protecting me, but from what?
Most of my friends and my family aren't about Liz and I being together. And
Richard has been my friend for 15 years. And the minute he found out that Liz and I were back together and engaged, I mean, he turned his back on me.
There was no warning. We were there supporting you
right.
while you're crying. And then the last thing you told me about Liz is, I'm good, I'm moving on. This is the first relationship Ed's had since his divorce, and he's desperate. They're both insecure, and they're both selfish.
It's been about 4 months since I've seen Richard. Rich had such a huge impact on me breaking up with Liz. Richard, to this day, still does not approve of Liz and I's relationship, because we did a lot of things to each other. And he's still stirring up trouble with my family and my friends. So I want my relationship with Liz to be successful. And Richard either needs to get on the train or, you know, jump off. Hey.
What's that?
I asked Richard to meet up with me tonight. He's having me meet him in this park. I'm not quite sure why we're meeting here. It's a dark, creepy park. I don't know, it kind of feels like I'm making a drug deal.
How are you?
Good.
Think in 4 months, I haven't seen you. A little surreal seeing Ed in person after 4 months. A lot hasn't been said in this time period, and it's overdue. Liz definitely fears my influence because I've been there the whole time, and I'm always gonna tell him the truth. I think Liz, she's an opportunist. She's not here for the right reasons, and that was my initial reaction when I found out that they got engaged.
I know you're mad, you know?
I know you want me to be happy for you, like that, but are you sure, Ed? Like, this is the person you want to be with? This person that tried to destroy you, that tried to take you down, you know, like...
Well, Richard, what about what I did to her? I mean, I broke up with her 8 times via text.
I know that.
I know. I mean, I was a head.
Right.
I was a head.
And I told you were too, along the way, too.
But in my heart, that's after 6 months of therapy and 6 months of total separation, I realized that's who I wanted to be with. I tell you I'm engaged, and it was just... hate,
dude.
Right?
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
I'm not...
but you just come out of the blue.
But Richard, it came out of the blue for me too.
That's because you're impulsive. You're impulsive. If you walk across the street and you got hit by a car once, wouldn't I say, hey, Ed, are you sure you want to cross this street again? You got hit the last time.
Rich, I choose Liz. That's it, and you can't accept it. I'm choosing her over everyone. My mom doesn't accept her. My daughter doesn't accept her.
What about your mom right now?
Mom's giving me the guilt trip. I'm like, look, Mom, I love you.
Your mom called me yesterday.
She calls and you talk to her every day. Don't you think that's kind of weird?
Well, no.
I do.
Not as close as we've been as friends and family.
Let my mom adopt you as her son. She likes you more than I do. I just don't need to see it. Richard and my mom were sort of close when we were friends, but now that Liz and I are back together, he is... formed this new level of a relationship with my mom. Who talks to somebody else's mom on a daily basis? That's kind of weird. I love my mom to death, but me being with Liz is not gonna hurt you. It's not gonna hurt my daughter. It's not gonna hurt my mom.
Well, cause still.
Period.
Can you still at least help her do, like?
I've done everything I can.
I don't know about that, dude.
I need Rich to stop putting ideas in my mom's head. It's impeding our relationship. I'm very worried that, you know, God forbid something should happen. She's 82. 2 years old, and I wouldn't want her leaving this world being mad at me. Until you're ready to accept my choice and Liz, I can't be around you.
I'm still your friend, bro. We've been friends for 16 years, and I don't just drop you like that. After 15 years of friendship, it's hard to swallow. I can just look into his eyes and I know I'm not talking to my friend. You know, there's somebody else I'm talking to now, and there's some influence there, but it's his life. He's got to figure this out.
I'm choosing to be with Liz. You don't support it. So what do you want to talk about? That's it.
That's it.
I go my way, you go yours.
Yeah, and that's so okay with you. It's an ultimatum. You're saying either you accept my decision and who I'm going to be with, or you're out of my life. That's the thing that bothers me.
Rich, I love Liz. I want to marry Liz.
That's fine. Do that. No one's stopping you.
Richard is someone that's been very important to me in my life. Somebody that I trusted more than my own brother. And it's hard, you know, to have a conversation with someone that will most likely end our friendship. But if I want my relationship with Liz to work, I don't have a choice. Like, I'm risking everything. Like, I literally have no one. I'm all in.